Hi, I'm Eric Paul, the Chemistry Guru, and you are watching H2 Chem Hacks, making H2 Chemistry simpler, one video at a time. Now let's further this discussion by talking about how our acidic buffer and alkaline buffer can maintain pH and remove H+ and OH- when it's added to this buffer solution. Now if you look at our acidic buffer, again we're using CH3COH and CH3CO- Na+ as an example. Now we know that a buffer is just a mixture of a conjugate acid-base pair. So the first thing we have to do is we have to find out who is the acid and who is the base. Obviously, this is the acid and this CH3CO- is conjugate base. Now remember, the acid is supposed to be responsible for removing OH-, the base is responsible for removing H+. So the equations that I'll write down to show how this buffer removes H+ and OH- will just be an acid-base reaction between H+ and CH3CO- and OH- and CH3COH. So when H+ is added, it will be removed by the base. So I'll just write out the acid-base reaction between H+ and CH3CO-. So in this case, I show that H+ is removed, pH is maintained. Now similarly, when I add OH-, the acid CH3COH will be responsible for removing the OH-. So you notice in this case, again, the OH- is removed, so pH of this buffer solution is maintained. Now we can calculate the pH of this buffer solution by the following equation. Now the equation is given by pH equals to pKa plus log concentration of salt over concentration of acid. Now pKa, of course, it represents the acid dissociation constant of our acid. Now in this case, it's not ambiguous. Inside this buffer, I only have one acid and one base, so therefore it must represent the Ka value for my CH3COH. Acid, again, is clearly CH3COH. So that for the salt must be its conjugate base, CH3CO-. Now again, if you look at the alkaline buffer, the idea is the same. Inside this buffer, there's an acid and there's a base. Ammonia will function as the base. NH4+ is its conjugate acid, will function as the acid. So my base is responsible for removing H+. My acid will remove OH-. So what happens when I add H+ to this alkaline buffer? It will be removed by the base. So we just need to write down acid-base reaction between H+ and ammonia. So you can see that the H+ is removed, so therefore pH is maintained. Now similarly, when I add OH-, it will be removed by the acid. So I need to write down acid-base reaction between OH- and NH4+. So my OH- is removed, so therefore the pH is maintained. For an alkaline buffer, there's also a buffer equation that you can use. Now the buffer equation for an alkaline buffer is given as pOH, which is equals to my pKb plus log concentration of salt divided by concentration of the base. So pKb again for base dissociation constant, very clearly represents the dissociation constant of the base. So in this case, again between NH3 and NH4+, it's not ambiguous, it must represent the Kb value for ammonia because ammonia is the base. Now, for the term plus log salt over base, base again will be my ammonia. So therefore, salt will be my conjugate acid, NH4+. So hopefully after this particular discussion, we have a better understanding of our buffer, which is essentially a mixture of a conjugate acid-base pair. Now we've also gone through how to write out equations to show how our acidic and alkaline buffer can remove H plus and OH minus, so therefore maintain pH. We've also went through how to calculate the pH of the acidic buffer as well as an alkaline buffer. If you have enjoyed this video, please share this with your friends. To learn more about H2 chemistry, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Follow me on Facebook, Instagram or Twitter. If you want to know more about my H2 chemistry classes at Nishan, please visit my website. Thank you for watching H2 Chem Hacks. I hope I've made H2 chemistry simple for you. I'll see you next time.